We are carrying an ocean inside our skin, and all the cells in our body are living in that ocean. Hello, in this video, we will understand the concept of milieu interior with analogy of Earth. Let's get started. We live on Earth. The Earth provides the atmosphere where we can survive. If we go into the space, we die. The outside space is not suitable for our survival. But if the Earth travels through the space, we are safe on the Earth. That is because the Earth takes our safe environment wherever it goes into the space. Thus, we live on same constant environment of Earth, no matter where we are in the space. When it comes to the body is like Earth. Each cell in the body is like living things on the Earth. And the atmosphere is like extracellular fluid that covers all the cells. It provides a safe place for all the cells to live. For isolated cells outside the body, it's hard to survive extreme weathers. However, inside the body, cells are safe even if the body goes through the changing weathers. That is because the internal environment of the cells remains constant no matter what's the outer condition. This internal environment of the body is called milieu interior. It literally means internal environment. It's basically the extracellular fluid of the body. Milieu exterior is physical surrounding of the body. The concept of milieu interior and exterior was given by Claude Bernard in 1878. Evolutionary perspective of this concept is also interesting. Millions of years back, life began as a unicellular organism in ocean. Medium of life for that cell was ocean. Then came multicellular organisms, and eventually more complex organisms started appearing. Today we have came out of water, but medium of life for each cell is still like the same ocean. Now we call that ocean extracellular fluid. It's like we are carrying an ocean inside the skin, and all the cells in the body are living in that ocean. The evidence for this is composition of extracellular fluid. It's rich in NaCl or salt, which is also one of the main constituents of ocean water. Thus, in simple words, this ocean of extracellular fluid is our internal environment or milieu interior. Now one last point. An interesting implication of concept of milieu interior is that some content of body are not actually inside the body at all. For example, content of gastrointestinal tract. Although physically inside the body, it's not inside our milieu interior. It's actually continuous with milieu exterior. Other examples are content of sweat duct, renal tubule and subsequent part of urinary tract, and respiratory tract. They are all continuous with external environment. Do you know what's the exact border between the two environments? It's the epithelium. Wherever our body is coming in contact with external environment, it's the epithelium in between the two. For example, skin and all the structures mentioned here. I hope you now understand the concept of milieu interior. All the cells, organs, and organ systems contribute in maintaining this internal environment at a constant level. But that's a topic for a different video. For now, this is it. If you feel this video will help your friends and colleagues, please share it with them too. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. At Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in next video.